MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Today we've got a good matchup ahead between the Philadelphia Phillies and the San Diego Padres. It's Padres Baseball on the show, and it comes your way next. Joey Lucchesi gets the start for San Diego in this one. Ben Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, this guy's done a real good job on the year keeping the opponent's batting average down. Both righties and lefties coming into this one, hitting under 250 against this guy. He's been good all season long.
Now at the plate, Gene Segura. He will lead this one off today.
Leading off the afternoon for Philadelphia, the shortstop, Gene Segura.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Underway now in the Sunday finale as the game's first pitch is taken for ball one. Guys, these Padres, as they take the field this afternoon, come in trying to bounce back from a loss last time out, but they've been in good form lately, 5-2 over their last seven.
Hey, thanks, Matty. This is a big one here, D-Row. They've won two of the first three of this series. This swing game here, you'd like to win three out of four. I know it, you're at this point, but boy, a split certainly would not be good for this ball club right now.
Yeah, Dan, to win the first two games, all right, you can live with dropping the third game of the set, but you don't want to end this 2-2. You work too hard early to not win this series.
Two balls and a strike to count. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Here now the 2-2. Will not catch the zone, ball three. Slow little roller to third. Throw on to first and a time, one away.
That is covered. The second baseman, Jose Peralta.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And digging into bat next, it'll be Jose Peraza. First pitch on its way. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. Lucchesi has a reputation, or a knack, if you will, for working himself out of tough situations when he finds himself there. A lot of relief pitchers are known for that, obviously, but as a starter, that's certainly a valuable characteristic to have.
Yeah, again, I'm going to tell you who likes this. The bullpen likes it, and the manager likes this, because most pitchers are going to get into trouble at least one or two times during the course of a start, and it's nice to know as a manager that you have a guy that's out there that can pitch with men on base and wiggle out of some tough jams. This guy's made a living doing this in his career.
Takes this the other way to right. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Check that out right there. I love me some of that. Staying inside the baseball, moving it the other way. Sometimes a pitcher can execute his pitch. It doesn't mean the batter can't do it.
Into the box now, Mark Withenshaw. He comes into this one having hit safely in his last five games. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Chopper to short. He's got it to second for one. On to Hosmer, a double play, and that ends the inning. One hit in the inning, but that gets erased. And now the Padres get their first opportunity in a scoreless ballgame. Martin Perez, Venezuelan left-hander, will be the man on the mound. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, we're looking at a real solid starting pitcher right here. You take a look at that ERA, anywhere between 3.5 and 4, but I'll tell you what he does know how to do. He knows how to get people out, and he can minimize the damage. He knows how to control the running game. He does a lot of things right. If he does all those things, expect a real solid performance in this one.
Number digging in, number 28. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Ball one.
A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Dan, D-Row, these Phillies, as they begin play here today, they come in looking to make it 2 in a row as they were winners last time out.
Hey, Matty V, you know, if there's such a good thing as splitting a series, D-Row, this is the one. They lose the first two games of this series, win game three. They'd like nothing more than to split this series and win game four.
Yeah, Bobby Cox always used to say, you got to take care and beat the teams you're supposed to beat and then play 500 against a really good team. They have a chance to do that exactly today. Drop the first two, but if they can win today, they split this series and move on.
And the off-balance throw will be too late, so a good effort that time, but it's an infield single.
I know that has to be frustrating from a pitcher's standpoint, but nice execution, nice hustle. Bottom line, nice hustle. Pitcher's still one good pitch away from getting a double play.
You know, D-Row, one of the things you want to do is make quality pitches as a pitcher. And there's not much you can do right there. You make a pretty good pitch, and the next thing you know, you have a leadoff single on an infield ground ball.
And prior to the first pitch, you look to first. Back in standing. At the plate, Owen Miller. Pitch out. Nothing doing. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Reined in. Segura for one. On to first. The double play. Here's Manny Machado now, having a very nice year, currently second in the NL batting chase.
There's a lot of ways to get on base. Base hit, a walk, hit by pitch. This guy's in the top five on base percentage. He does a little bit of all of those things.
Here's the pitch.
Pitching a little bit backwards in this situation, I'd expect a hitter to be sitting off speed.
Two out, nobody on. And he falls behind 0-2.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
High in the air out to center field. Withenshaw will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Padres go down quietly. We are still scoreless. Here's Bryce Harper now. What a season he's having. Entering play, leading the league in two of the three triple crown categories.
Yeah, this guy's got the home run and runs batted in thing figured out for the triple crown, but he's not in the top five in the batting average, and he wants to win the triple crown, so he's going to have to make up a lot of ground.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Like that pitch there, lefty on lefty matchup. Curveball away to a lefty. Smart pitch.
0-1, the count to Bryce Harper. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone. One and two now as that one's fouled off. There's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2. Just hung in there on that one. Another foul ball. And a good curveball gets him swinging for out number one.
That was a good job there of using the batter's aggressiveness against him.
He was putting up a good fight and fouling a lot of balls off. So as a pitcher, it's a great idea to expand the zone even more and make the hitter really chase after something that's even hard to foul off.
To plate now, Justin Turner. Guess he'll take the breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0. He'll check in here at 256, 18 homers and 44 RBIs. Now a breaking ball, but it's low. Turner, California-born ball player. He was selected in the seventh round during the first-year player draft of 2006.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
On deck, there's Andrew McCutchen. He'll hit next. Change up too low. He walked him.
And with the bases empty, you don't feel bad about walking that guy. He's capable of taking deep every time he digs in, so it's not the worst thing in the world to work around him if you can.
Now at the plate, Andrew McCutchen. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Set, here it comes, and a sinker gets too low there, into the dirt in fact. Turner, base runner at first with one out.
He's going.
There he goes towards second, and there's a base hit on the line, and they'll have runners at the corners following the one out single.
Boy, is that a thing of beauty right there. Hit and run to perfection, D-Row. Runners at first to third.
That's exactly what you're trying to do. You don't see it in today's game too much. There's a lot of moving parts, a lot of walks, homers, and strikeouts. But right there, manager sets it in motion, and the hitter just executes to perfection.
Coming to the plate now, Rhys Hoskins. Power a big part of his game as he enters this contest, number 5 in the National League home run race.
You know, D-Row, we're into the summer right now. This guy's power's been off the charts. Looks like he's going to be able to do this all season long.
I think he is, Dan, and the ball's going to start flying now. Weather's starting to warm up in certain parts of the country. We're getting into the middle, late part of summer. You're going to see some epic home runs down the stretch.
Strike one to start the at-bat. Oh and one, here it comes. Ball and two strikes.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
No score here as we play inning number 2. Swing and a miss got him reaching. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Trying to hang a zero, here's the pitch. Against left-handed pitching so far this season, Collins is holding on to a batting average way down in the 210s.
He'd be the first to tell you he's not happy with his batting average this season, but he can beat you in a variety of different ways, and he has to because he wouldn't be here otherwise.
Weak grounder down the first baseline, but this will be a foul ball, and it's still 0-2. Runners at the corners, two men out. The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now. Two balls and two strikes to the Phillies catcher. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Don't want to forget about it. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 home. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And a base hit as the Phillies will strike first in this one. They lead it 1-0.
Boy, talking about picking your teammate up after that strikeout, D-Ro. Big, big, and I mean big, two-run RBI single.
Yeah, way to come through for your team. When you take the donut off your bat right there, you're trying to pick up your teammate. He had the right game plan, didn't come outside it, stayed through the baseball, and was able to come through.
So now to the plate, Martin Perez. And he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one.
Hey, here's a case right here, D-Ro, where as a pitcher, you could really help himself. With a two-out RBI here, this would be a huge run if he could drive this run in.
Dan, this is already a win-win in my book for the eight-hole hitter to grab an RBI knock. Not only does he get the pitcher up, he turns the lineup over for next inning. This is unbelievable.
A one ball, two-strike count to the Phillies pitcher.
Well, he's been laboring a bit through these first two innings of work. That's 37 pitches, and ideally he'd be closer to 27 instead.
Phillies have an early 1-0 lead here in inning number two. Trying to get him to chase the curveball away, but it breaks outside. 2-2 now.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
2-2, here it is. Curveball, and he buckled him, but it's full 3-2.
Wow, this is a pretty good at bat right here. From down in the count 0-2 to work the count back to 3-2, and he's seen a lot of pitches too.
Payoff pitch on its way. It's swung on and popped up, crossing into foul territory now behind third. And Machado will make the catch here, and that ends the inning. Phillies will have to be content with just the one. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two. Philadelphia is on top, 1-0. Here's Matt Adams. He was hitless in the shutout last night. First delivery to him on the way. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Hey, it looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
Anytime a pitcher locates a fastball on the inside corner, it's going to be a tough pitch to hit. That one was spot on, and he had no answer for it.
First baseman Eric Hosmer is in as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Lifetime against Martin Perez. He's had some success, 5-for-11. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. According to the career numbers on the back of his baseball card, Hosmer has a slugging percentage a little over .425, a respectable number. Rounded weakly down the line toward third. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Two-two. Bouncer to the left side. And there's out number two.
Fielder,
So here's Will Myers, comes off an 0 for 4 in last night's ball game. Comes the first pitch. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Well, and he misses with it, one and one.
You know he wants that on the mound, especially if it would have made the count 0-2. Didn't get it though, so now you have to make another quality pitch on 1-1.
And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike.
Ball three.
And there's a fastball well off the plate inside.
So that's two pitches in a row above the belt. As a hitter, that's what you're looking for, especially when it's a day game and the ball is carrying. That just wasn't a good enough pitch to hit.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a liner, but foul. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over. Three up, three down for San Diego. They trail this one 1-0. Ready now, Gene Segura. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest. First offering on its way. Curveball looked at here for strike one.
All ones to count.
And a sinker's in there for a called strike, and he forges ahead, nothing in two.
Two well executed pitches at the knees right there, but I know this hitter's looking for something up.
Down the first baseline. Down the third baseline, but a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch.
Ball back in.
Now this guy's a grinder, fouls off good pitches, and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
Ball and two strikes, here's the pitch. Takes this the other way to right, and that's a base hit. 1-for-2 in his first couple of plate appearances. So the Phillies get a man on to start out the inning.
Well, last time this guy had some success, but he can't seem to get it going here. In fact, he's given up more hits in this one than he did his entire last outing. And we're only in the third inning.
And here's Jose Peraza. So take a look at the pitch. Too low, it's ball one. A base hit in his first trip. Now a throw over, but the runner's back easily. Nobody out, runner on first. Hit hard to the right side. Foul. A 1-1 pitch. In the dirt here. Good job there as the count goes to 1-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. The runner at first with no outs here. that just about got away as it misses inside for a ball.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Now the payoff pitch home. Belted high in the air out to left. Ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
The center fielder, number 24, Mark Withenshaw.
Into the box, Mark Withenshaw. Now a throw over to first, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. Pitch coming, here it is. Pitch is a cold strike, the throw. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down.
That's pretty savvy base running, right? A lot of pitchers don't throw over twice in a row, so I think he was going on first movement, and it worked out nicely.
Ready with the nothing in one pitch to third. And that's the second out.
Now batting, right fielder, Bryce Harper.
And Bryce Harper will dig in at the plate. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Set and the pitch. Curveball, but it misses well out of the zone. And it looked like ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1. The belt kicks and deals. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count. Is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
Two out here and a runner at second. Hit hard to the right. Foul. Two and two. Here it is.
Offensively, but first and foremost, we need to start by putting the ball in play more often. There's too much swing and miss in our game, and the stats do back that up as they currently rank near the bottom of the league in strikeouts, so that appears to be an area of emphasis going forward, guys.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Dirks and Profar digs in next. He's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. First pitch on its way.
Well, that's off
Perez, a left-hander who goes an even 6 feet. He's a 9-year major league vet. Hit hard to third. And there's one down now. Obviously a big game as you check out the standings on your screen, and you can see their lead is just one game entering play here today. So the base is empty here with one away. And into bat next is catcher Wellington Castillo. First offering on its way.
Ball one. Ball one,
one out, nobody on. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And he'll put this away for the second out.
That's exactly what they wanted out of that pitch up in the zone. They took him up the ladder, and he couldn't get up to it. So that was an easy pop-up. Well-executed pitch there.
Up next, it'll be the pitcher for the Padres, Joey Lucchese, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Pitch on the way.
Hey!
Man, this guy's in a good groove right now. Seven straight retired. He's locked in.
Two out, nobody on. Now a flare out toward right center. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Boy, Dewey, you're talking about frustrating as a pitcher.
Yeah,
a pitcher up for two outs. And he extends the inning there with a base hit.
Yeah, it's funny. I've hit eighth in my career, and the grind was to try and get the pitcher up so you can waste that out and flip the lineup over. This guy took it into his own hands and did just that. By getting him out, now we could have some issues here.
Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And that misses low and away, ball one. Two out with the man at first. And he misses low with it, 2-0. Fouls this one off. Now the 2-1 pitch. Good eye there as he works the count back full.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Good battle. Count remains full. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he turns on this one and yanks it foul and back out of play. Working for the punch out and the offering. Now a swing and he pops him up. This is right out in front of the mound. Perez is there to make the catch and the side is retired. Padres lead one. It remains 1-0. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Matt, I talked with Philadelphia's manager during the break about the Phillies' offensive production to this point. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Digging in now for Philadelphia, Justin Turner, as we begin the top of the fourth.
Justin Turner.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. Action now in the Padre bullpen as it looks like a right-hander is getting loose out there. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And low, it's a ball and a strike. 2-1.
Well, those were a couple of close pitches right there in the inner part of the zone. Hitters will tell you, pitches in that location are tough to do anything with.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And he'll flip on first to record the out. So with one away, let's punch up the graphic and show you the pitch speed comparison for the two starters here in the fourth inning. And you can see both guys bringing it pretty good in this one. 95 on one hand, 92 on the other. So the next hitter to dig in will be Andrew McCutchen. First pitch of the at bat on its way. And he takes a called strike, 0-1. One and one to Andrew McCutchen. A little bit outside, 2-1. But picked up on a hop. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first. So that'll go down as an E4, as he certainly had his problems that time at second base. So a runner on first with one out now, and that'll bring up Rhys Hoskins. From the belt, kicks and deals. One run, four hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. Line drive to center field. And he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch. Wow.
Oh, and a highlight reel catch there, no doubt. He laid out to sacrifice his body, brought it in, and secured it all the way to the ground. You know his pitcher really appreciates an effort like that.
Digging in, Zach Collins. He came through with an RBI single in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and he's got to feel super confident right now. He's the only real offense in this game. Guys on the mound have been executing every pitch.
Not where you want the changeup, but he gets away with it for a strike.
Hey, I don't care what league you're in, American, National, if you're playing on Mars, if you get a heater down the middle of the plate as an eight-hole hitter, you better be swinging back.
Behind 0-2 now. Open to send him packing. Pitch on its way. A swing and a miss at a sinker. Strikeout retires the side. Inning is over. Phillies strand one. They lead it 1-0. Bottom of the inning now. And set to go is the second baseman, Owen Miller.
The second baseman, Owen Miller.
Here comes the first pitch. Lifted out towards straightaway center field. Withenshaw is there, and he has it for the first out.
The first baseman, number 20, Manny Machado.
So with one gone in the inning now, that brings in Manny Machado. first offering on its way.
Nope, at the ball. Ball one, no strike.
Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. Outside part of the plate, the changeup is in there.
You can bet he wants that one back at the plate right now. That's a pitch you normally see a guy drive if he has the right approach going.
1-1. Hit sharply, but caught down there at third. As he'll hang on here to record the now second out.
No left fielder.
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Matt Adams. He's 0-for-1 thus far. First pitch coming. Here it is.
1-0.
Swing and a miss. That one tied him up. Yanked the slider across that time. Laid off for a ball.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
The 2-1 home. Grounded up the first baseline. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. No runs, two hits, and one error for the Padres so far. Pops this one up. Peraza waits on it, and that retires the side. Padres down in order. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Ready to go in the top of the fifth. Leading and that'll bring up the pitcher, Martin Perez. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Scorched to third. Taken in by Machado. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
The batter, number two, shortstop, Gene Segura.
Gene Segura standing in. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Curveball just misses apparently. 1-0. So far this year against southpaws, Segura is holding on to a batting average way down in the 210s.
Matty, he struggled this season against left-handed pitching, but maybe a little shot of confidence with the manager putting him in the lineup.
Right to the second baseman, and that's the second out.
Jose Peralta.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and digging into bat next, it'll be Jose Peraza. First pitch on its way. This is in the air to right. Long run for the right fielder. Great diving effort there, but it'll just tip off his glove, and it's a base hit. And a good effort to bring it back in quickly, but he's in at second base with a double.
Their own pitcher is absolutely dealing right now. So this is a big moment in this game. If his teammates can pick him up and drive him in now, that might be all they need to get the W here.
Into the box now, Mark Withenshaw. As the first pitch sinker misses to him, it's ball one. 0-for-2 for him to this point. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Grounder down the line at third, but a foul ball, 1-1. Hit hard down the line. This will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. The set and the 1-2. Drilled down the line. This is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. So swing and a line drive, but foul. One and two, here it is. Making him sweat out there, the seventh pitch coming up. Trying to get him to chase the curveball away, but it breaks outside. Two and two now.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
He set the 2-2. Hit down the third baseline. Here's the 2-2. Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. And that ends the inning. Danger averted following the two-out double. We're back with more on a Sunday afternoon following this. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with San Diego's manager during the inning break about the Padres' offensive production at this point. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitches from the strikes.
Way to go. Thank you, Heidi. First pitch of the at-bat. Right side. Hoskins grabs it cleanly. Throw to first is in time for the first down. So still nothing against him on the scoreboard here in the fifth as we check out the league leaderboard for team ERA. And you can see there, they're just one place off the top spot in the NL in that category. Riding in once again, Will Myers. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. First pitch coming, here it is.
Nope, out there.
The 1-0. Swung on and missed strike one.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel of that one.
And now here's a ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. On the move is Harper. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Now batting, the shortstop, Derek Stead. Throw ball.
First pitch on its way. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. And he just misses inside with the fastball there. Lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
One of the best ways to keep a guy uncomfortable is to pound him inside. They're doing that, and this one caught the zone.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit to third. Turner's got it. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for San Diego. They still trail 1-0. Emilio Pagan takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 15, Emilio.
Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. Here comes the first pitch. Ball. Fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. Now the 1-0. Misses. Ball two. Pagan. 28 years old. He's in his fourth season as a major league player. Now the 2-0. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Here's the 2-1 home. To 2-2 now.
Wow, great pitch right there, right? Changing speeds. How about that straight changeup? How about that swing? Howdy, if you're waving at me.
Fouled away. Fouled off. Two, one more time. Lifted the other way out to left center. Left fielder giving chase. He gets there and makes the play for the first down.
Now batter, the third baseman, Justin Turner.
Stepping up to the plate, Justin Turner. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1.
Hey, if you're able to blow a first pitch fastball by a guy, gotta believe that pitch is coming again right here.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And he lays off for ball one. Now a swing as he shoots this down the right field line. And a fair ball as this will head out toward the 322 sign in right. He'll get it into second. And he's in there easily at second with a one-out double.
When it left his bat, I thought it might curve foul, but he manages to squeak it just inside the right field line for a well-hit line drive double. By the time the right fielder tracked it down, he was easily into second.
Here's Andrew McCutchen now. As he'll take a look at ball one. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Left fielder is on the move. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
The first baseman, number 17, Reese Hoskins.
And that'll bring up the Sacramento product, Reese Hoskins. No hits to this point. First offering on its way. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Inside, 2-0.
No reason to give in to him here with the base open. Putting him on base just gives your defense more ways to help get you out of this.
Here's the 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. There's ball four.
It was obvious when the count ran to 2-0 that they were not going to give this guy anything to hit. Sometimes you have to pick your battles, and they're going to try their luck with the next hitter.
Digging in once again, Zach Collins. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matt. He's got to find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
Boy, the Phillies have been looking for some offense all game long. They've yet to find it. Let's hope they can find it pretty soon.
In there, and he's ahead 0-2 now.
Sometimes guys get a little less aggressive pitching with a couple of runners on base, but not here. That was two good fastballs to take control of the bat and get the count to 0-2.
Nothing in two, the pitch. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. Phillies leave a couple, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Here's the catcher, Wellington Castillo. He'll start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, only two hits so far, Matt, and not very many hard hit balls either. We'll see if they can start making some adjustments.
Here's the first pitch to him. Strike taken as the curveball drops into the bottom part of the zone. Now a fastball off the plate away. Ball and a strike. One-one. Takes this the other way to right. But this will not elude the right fielder's grasp as he ranges over to handle it for the first down.
Talk about hitting into some rough luck. That was an absolute bullet to the outfield that gets caught, and he would have represented the tying run.
Tommy Pham will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Fly ball out toward left center field. McCutcheon on the move. He gets there and makes a fine running play for the second out.
Now batting, number 28.
The San Diego batting order turns over and set to go number 28. And Dan, it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. And this one's too far inside, ball two. Lifted the other way down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
I know we want to focus on the offense and how bad they've been so far, but can we give some love to the pitcher? He has had these
guys. And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Padres down in order. They trail this one 1-0. Kyle Bearclaw is on the pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
For the Padres, number 20, Kyle Bearclaw.
So here now is the pitcher, Martin Perez. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
The pitcher, number 33, Martin Perez.
First delivery to him on the way. Bit of an ill-advised swing that time as that ball got in on him. Bearclaw, or Bear for short, he was selected in the seventh round during the first-year player draft of 2012.
Man, coming out of the late rounds, you have to grind for everything. Nothing is given to you. And this guy has turned himself into a very solid big league ball player. That's a big accomplishment.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and have backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
And that'll bring up Gene Segura as he swings and misses at a first pitch fastball, 0-1. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. set with the 0-1. Foul tip held on to behind the plate at strike two.
Aggressive swings out of him to start this at bat, but he hasn't been able to put the ball in play. Time to use that aggressiveness and make him chase now.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
In now, Jose Peraza, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one.
Man, that's seven straight strikes to start this inning. He's got a chance at an immaculate inning.
And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Two out, nobody on. It's 1-2.
Count is 1-2.
Pitch on the way. There's a breaking ball that couldn't quite catch the inside. Set to deal on 2-2. High in the air out to center field. Myers is under it. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. But they're up 1-0. Now batting, Owen Miller. And Dan, he and his fellow top of the order hitters haven't really offered much help for this lineup so far.
Your 1-2-3 guys are the ones you look to generate a lot of action. They just haven't been up to the task so far in this one. Still time for them to turn it around, though. We'll see if it happens.
Here comes the first pitch. Right side, hit hard. And this is through into right field, so the time runs aboard to kick off the inning. Miller took until the seventh, but he gets his first hit of the game here, and that'll extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, he didn't come out of the what he was trying to do all day. He kept the front shoulder up, kept the ice water in his veins, and didn't try and get too big. Extends the hit. Nice job.
You know, D-Ro, I talked to him before the game about the streak, and he said the toughest part is he hopes to get hits early in the game to take the pressure off. He had to wait for the seventh inning in this one to come through.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Well, he's having a good amount of success here, Dan, even though he hasn't really gotten a ton of swings and misses.
Yeah, but for him, Matt, he's more of a pitch-to-contact kind of guy, and obviously it's working so far, and the way he pitches, it really keeps his pitch count down.
It's going to be back to some serious T-work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Misses, ball two. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a miss there on a late breaking slider as he set down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. Nothing doing there for the Friars. It remains 1-0. Jose Castillo has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 65. Okay. Here
he goes. New inning set to get underway, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Mark Withenshaw. Ready, here's the first offering. Well above the letters with the fastball that time. The 1-0 is taken for ball two. This is lined to left, and that will make him 1-for-4 in this one. So that leadoff base hit means considerable speed aboard to start out the inning. Cut it close here, but he comes through in the eighth to extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he was staring at his last at bat right there, probably his last at bat. Would have been tough to get him another AB in this one, but he's able to get it done.
Hey, better late than never. And I'm sure when he walked in that batter's box right there, he's thinking this very well could be my last AB of this game. So if I'm going to keep this streak alive, I'm going to have to do it right now.
The stretch and a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one.
He's good, he's good.
On the move for second, a pitch out, the throw, and just great defensive baseball there as they will nail him at second on the pitch out.
Wow, that's a big-time throw right there. And it's a tall task to throw him out stealing the bag. But he got rid of it quickly, and it was a good job down there applying the quick tag. They'll have to feel good about that one.
Now the 2-0. Wanted to go after the slider, but he holds off. 3-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Gets him to swing and miss there. 3-2.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
This will be fouled away. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Adams is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two.
Now batting.
Time to bring you up to date on the numbers for our two starters. It's our starter comparison, and the hometown nine have had trouble generating much by way of hits, as you can see by the left side of your screen. Now to the plate, Justin Turner, 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. First offering on its way. Hit on the ground to third. Machado is there. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. So no runs on one base hit, no errors, and no one left on. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. The Phillies lead it 1-0. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. And standing in here to the first baseman, Eric Hosmer.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
Hard hit ball towards the hole. And this is through into right field, so the time runs aboard to kick off the inning.
Boy, it was a tough time to get that single, and maybe now they can start to get some traffic on the bases.
Yeah, absolutely. And ambush tactics, not always the play. You want to drive that pitch count up and get into that bullpen, but sometimes that's the play.
Here's Will Myers. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Coming, here it is. The breaking ball there had him frozen, strike one. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Nobody out, runner on first. Outside for a ball, one and one.
I'm seeing all the signs of fatigue right now. This is when you really have to bear down mentally as a pitcher. Struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
And the 3-1. Back up the middle. And that's through for this first base hit in this one.
There's a hard-hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get glove on a hard single. You watch your lips right there, Dan. Sent it back right where it came.
Philadelphia manager on his way out to the mound now. And we're going to have a pitching change as that's going to be off for his starter this afternoon. So as he departs, his fate is still up in the air. He could stand to win it. He could get a no decision. He could even be on the hook for the loss if both runners come around to score.
Hector Neris
is on the pitch here in the eighth with nobody out.
Number 50, Hector Neris.
C.J. Abrams will come on now and pinch run here.
C.J. Abrams.
Digging in the switch hitter, Jurickson Profar. And his guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, Matt, they've been really shut down so far in this one. They've had runners on base, but haven't been able to string anything together. This has to be a productive at bat right here. I know you want to drive the run in and get the RBI, but you have to find a way, bare minimum, to move this runner over.
1-0 count, here it is.
That's ball two. One strike. That's ball three.
In today's game, everybody's trying to work off the mound north-south, trying to elevate that heater. He wanted that pitch right there, but I can tell you as an offensive player, I'd rather give you 6 inches off east-west than to have you call that high fastball.
And that one is a called strike as he's rebounded to run it full now, 3-2. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. But he makes the catch for the out. Fernando Tatis Jr. will get a chance with a runner in scoring position here, so pinch hit now with one away. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Looking at his lifetime numbers, Tatis hits a little over the 270 mark. Now the 1-0. It's a slider taken for a ball.
Two balls, no.
Runner at second here with one man out. Good pitch there. Had him a little out in front. One, here it is. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Three and one, here it is. In the right field, that's a base hit. And the runner from second will stay put at third, so they're runners at the corners now with one away.
Double play it. Base hit right there, but you have to hold there, Devo, to make sure that gets down and isn't caught for a line drive double play.
Yeah, you have to play the game right there and respect the infield and respect the line drive. I know he wants to get a ribby for his buddy, but that's the way the game's played.
Stepping in now, number 28. Nope. So watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. And able to lay off the fastball away here. 2-1 now. Center. He is around first, heading for two. And a high bounce will take it over the outfield wall, and he kicks off the inning with a ground rule double. Next to bat will be Reese Hoskins. So take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. They'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. Now the 1-0.
That's ball three.
Definitely looking fastball here, and he got one, but that was good discipline to lay off and get himself into a 3-0 count.
From the belt, the pitch.
Aye. That was 3-1.
Down at the knees, but called a strike. Wow, it's 3-2 now. Now the payoff pitch home. Two down and missed strike three.
This has not been a weekend to remember for him. He's just been completely lost at the plate, flailing all over the place. Now that's his sixth strikeout of the series. They've really got him figured out.
At the plate, Zach Collins. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. And he lays off the pitch up and in ball two. Laid off down for ball number three.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Swing and a miss at the splitter, 3-1, and it's 3-2 now. Payoff pitch home. That's lifted the other way out to left. Left fielder is on the move. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning.
The pitcher, number 50, Patrick Miller.
Jake Bruce will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Number 23, Jay Bruce.
Hit hard to the right. Foul. Hold the lead. Here's the delivery. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. And now this crowd of 27,000 plus rise to their feet. Out in front. front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. Philly down to their last strike.
Ball one.
Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes. The set and the 1-2. One run game here in the top of the ninth.
That's a great take right there. Great pitch recognition. He let that one go. Opposite handed, that's coming across the plate. You might think he got a shot to stay inside that one.
He's set. And the 2-2.
Helpful.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Two out here and a runner at second. Away. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 home. Popped him up. Casilla moving to his left. Makes the pitch, and that's the ball game.
Yeah, the home crowd is loving it as they jump out in front and
pitching and defense game, 2-1, the final score this afternoon. The San Diego Padres came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Jose Castillo gets the win in relief, his second of the year. Martin Perez hits well, allowing only two earned, but ends up taking the loss. Kirby Yates earns the save out of the bullpen, 25th of the year. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.